What's up, builders? Okay, what is the goal of today? You make an AI agent. It's a chatbot, it's a voice agent, whatever it is. Okay, after you build it, how do your customers and clients update the information inside of it? Because I can tell you what I don't personally want. I don't want an email to Connor, hey, can we change this sentence here? I want the clients to have access to something that is stupid simple. And that's what we're going to do today. So a few weeks ago, Jacqueline and Voiceflow put out this video about automating your knowledge base updates inside of Notion. And this is a great video. I suggest you all go watch it. This is my version of this for me personally, because my problem with Notion is my clients don't have Notion accounts, and I don't want to ask them to say, hey, go log into this, make this. I don't want them to have like a new login and to learn like a new tool. So what does everybody have? They have a domain. And because they have a domain, they probably purchased it through Google, which gives them access to Google Drive. So my version of this is we're going to tie directly into Google Docs and Google Drive specifically. So I have this RAG agent template here, courteous of my good buddy Winston, if you're watching this, hello. But you'll note there's nothing in this knowledge base, okay? So if I asked it a question, it would come back with a not found here. So let's open up N8N, because that is what we're going to use here. I have a test folder in Google Drive, Connor test folder. And in here, I have this document. And I put the solar system information in here. My five-year-old daughter is really digging space at the moment. So we have some information on the planets. Okay, great. How do we tie this in to Voiceflow's API? So what is the first trigger that we want to initiate this workflow? Well, we want to set some sort of cron schedule. So we create a Google Drive node as the trigger for this workflow. And what it is going to do, you can set this schedule to whatever you want. I have this currently checking it every day at this hour. Trigger on changes involving a specific folder. So it looks at the entire folder from this list, Connor test folder. Now, to connect to your Google Drive account, this is actually a decent amount of steps that you have to go through. And you actually have to tie this into your Google Cloud account. Now, I'm not going to go through this full thing in this video because I want to keep it short. But N8N has some docs about how to do this. And if you want to watch me go through this, if you want me to make a video, just let me know in the comments. Otherwise, go read the docs. I'll put a link. Anyways, changes involving a specific folder, this test folder. Watch for file updated. You can also do a file created, and you can also create a second node that has file created and file updated in here. But I know what the doc is, right? Here's the doc, and if you can go update this and put your company information in here, put whatever you want inside of here. Okay, so this is the first node. What's the second thing? We actually need to download this file. So N8N has it to then upload it into Voiceflow's API. So once again, that same connection, we're going to download this file. Now, how does it know what to download? So we have the download operation here by ID, double curly bracket, JSON ID. Now, if you were to go create this event here, you're going to get this test event here, and you pin this data here. That way, you, on the left-hand side, you can see what the schema is. And then we can just kind of scroll down here. Where is our file ID? ID right here. So this is what you drag into here, and it will populate as JSON ID as an expression here. Now, here's the bottom part of this, which is important. I am converting this to a Word document. I am converting a Google Doc to a Word document. Now, I could have done this as text as well. But if you do a text file, you're also going to bring in all of, you know, if If the document has headings and certain formatting, it's going to bring those special characters into the text file, which will just add additional tokens into the LLM, which I don't want to do that. It's gonna muddy all of my chunks up. So anyways, Word document is what I want here. So we need a trigger when this file is updated in the Google Drive folder. Then we're gonna download the file, okay? So we're gonna test this. Click test. Here we go, we get an output. Now data, this is a special name that N8N attributes to this particular output. We will use this now on our VoiceFlow API call. So this HTTP request, if you click on this node, HTTP, so this is what this node is. We're gonna go pull up VoiceFlow docs here. Upload document file. So this is where we get the URL. You can see that it is a post request. If we take a look at the curl, we can look at the headers here. This is important. Accept application JSON. So we need to make sure that we're passing that, the right URL. Content type, multi-part form data. Okay, we scroll down. We need a file. So if we go through, one other really important one here is overwrite. Where is it? Here it is. We have to pass overwrite as a query parameter, and we need to set it to true. Because if it checks every day and it already exists, I want it to overwrite with the new information. So that's really important. All right, let's go through this. So we have a post. We have the URL, which we got from the docs. Authentication will set to none. We're going to pass query parameters. Using fields below. Name, overwrite, value true. Now, if you have fixed in here and write the word true, it will pass as a string and that will not work. You need an expression here that evaluates as true. So this is why you see double curly brackets, the word true, which then populates here. Here are my headers. Okay. So authorization, we're going to need our API key. Okay, and where we get this is if we open back up my agent and integration API keys. Here we go. Copy key, dump it right into N8N. Oh my gosh, Connor, you have a YouTube video and your API key is showing. Please go delete it. Don't worry. This is a test agent. Here we go. Next one, and you can add parameters here by clicking this button here and removing them. So accept application/JSON is the next one. And this is exactly right here. Now, something interesting here for content type, multi-part form data, I actually do not need to pass this. You can pass it, it's fine, but N8N is actually gonna handle this for us. So that's why I don't have it in here. Here's the important part. Send body, body content type, we need form data. We need to click N8N binary file because this is how we're going to be able to access the file that we just downloaded from the Google Drive. The name, this has to be file, F-I-L-E. Now, why is that the case? And that is because that is what the VoiceFlow API is expecting from us. This is my file, VoiceFlow API. Please accept it. Input data field name. This is another one that is unique to N8N. It is just the word data, which you'll see on the left-hand side is data. This is how we access it. Now, one important thing to note before I forget it, the name of this file you'll see is VoiceFlow KB auto updating .docx. The name of this file must have the extension in the name. Otherwise, this will not parse correctly, will not work. So if you're using .txt, it needs to be saved as .txt. It's a dot. If it's a Word document, .docx. So let's see if this works. So remember, I have, if I go to the knowledge base here, this is blank. I have absolutely nothing here. Let's test the workflow here. So this already went through because I pinned the data here, which is why this didn't trigger. I should unpin this. Back to Canvas. Why did it do this? Let's do a fresh fetch. I wonder why it's not spinning there. Anyways, it's working. Okay, so I got this green check here. Let's go check voice flow. And refresh. Hope this works. Here we go. Look at that. Voice flow KB auto updating .docx just now. So it just imported this file into here. If I click on here, it's going to show me the chunks. Look at this overview of the solar system. So it's got all of this stuff in here. I can pull this up, test your agent. What was something inside of there? The eight planets in the solar system are divided into two groups, terrestrial planets and gas giants. So let's ask that. What are the two groups of planets? The eight planets in the solar system are divided into two groups, terrestrial planets, rocky planets, and gas giants, also known as Jovian planets. Okay. So that is exactly what is inside of that document. That's not just some LLM response that's got, you know, a bunch of bullet points and stuff. This is specifically pulled from my Google Doc that I have created. And I will show you another example of this. Okay. So you see this document, it's got a couple pages. Okay. Let's go to the bottom here. Connor's favorite planet is, of course, Mars. Okay. It's red. Okay. Red is my favorite color. So you'll see at the top left, it's saving. So this just saved. Let's go run this in N8N again. So if I click test workflow again, here we go. Let's go. Back. Nope. Wrong bot. Just a sec. So let's close this for a second. Let's refresh. Probably didn't need to do that. Test your agent. What is Connor's favorite planet? Connor's favorite planet is, of course, Mars. So there we go. So this is a way to have a Google Doc connected into a VoiceFlow agent and then give it to your client, right? Because all I have to do now is go here and click this share button and say, here you go. Here's a link to this. And give it to them in an email. And then that way their company information changes. Can just update it themselves and they can understand where these answers are coming from because they have the document in front of them. So this works great for your customer facing, you know, business information where you don't have to have, you know, large database entries and a bunch of different things pulling from different directions. If you just need one kind of central knowledge base to pull queries from, this is a great automation to set up and give to your clients. So I will make sure to provide this JSON file so you can just download it yourself. And if you have any questions or want to modify this anyway, you've got VoiceFlow Docs here. There's a bunch of other things you can do with, you know, these APIs. And the same thing with N8N. You do whatever you want. The other thing to do here, which I'm probably going to do for this particular use case that I have, is I'm probably going to add an email, right? I go to email and where is create a message? Send a message. Here we go. Right? So I'm probably going to do some sort of like error checking, like just in case it doesn't go through. Like I want it to send me an email if this fails, or send it to the client when they update it and it's a successful one, because then they'll be like, oh, yeah, my bot is updated. Anyways, got any questions? Let me know. Happy building. Thanks.